Hi, this is Electronics. In this video, I'm going to tear down this Watson AS5451 5.1 audio system. Before the video starts, be sure to subscribe and press the bell to get notified when I upload a new video. To start the teardown, 6 Phillips head screws have to be removed, which are holding the backplate. I speed up the video at some parts while I take apart the system. After taking out the screws, the backplate can be pulled out. When the backplate is removed, a big circuit board is revealed. I disconnect the IR receiver and the speaker wires, so this way the board is separated completely from the box and the components. The remaining components in the box are the speaker, the IR receiver and the bass reflex tube. I would like to point out that the build quality of this audio system is good, as you can see the manufacturer placed seal around the box opening where the backplate is fixed in order to make the box acoustically better. The subwoofer speaker has a nominal resistance of 4 ohms. This is the main circuit board for the 5.1 audio system. Compared to the LTEC Lansing, it has a bigger and more complicated circuit board because a lot of extra features are implemented in this system. These extra features consist of IR remote control receiver circuit, 6 channels of audio with remote control of volume, bass and center. I made some high quality pictures of the circuit board so I can highlight the separate circuit parts more easier. A TDA2030A Class AB amplifier IC is used for the subwoofer. 3 pieces of TEA2025B Class AB stereo amplifiers for the 5 channel surround. 1 piece of TC9149 IR receiver IC. 4 pieces of TC9153 digital volume control IC. 1 piece of HEF4013BP flip-flop IC and 1 piece of HEF4066BP quad single pole single throw analog switch. Next, I will try to power it up and measure the voltages. Caution, mains voltage danger. Don't try this if you don't know exactly what you are doing. Mains voltage can lead to injury or death. All the wires are sealed, but still it can be dangerous. As you see, my multimeter senses the voltages, so handle with caution. Now I measure the rectified DC voltages on the board, which I measure on the big buffer capacitors. The lower one is for the TEA2025B surround amplifiers and other components like the IR receiver and volume ICs. The higher one is for the TDA2030A subwoofer amplifier IC. The voltages are coming in from the transformer on the yellow and the blue wires. The DC voltages are 13.4 volts for the TEA and other components, 40 volts for the TDA2030A. Note, these values are without load, which will decrease if the system is turned on and music played. I couldn't manage to turn on the circuit, so it is in standby mode. Before rectification, the AC voltages are 11.6 volts and 30 volts. One of the remaining components is the IR receiver module, which is held by 3 Phillips head screws and the transparent blue shield for it, which can be easily pushed out. Last but not least, the speaker. First, the protection grille must be pushed out, and after that, 4 Phillips head screws are holding the speaker. Before the video ends, I would like to show some high quality pictures of the speaker, transformer and the IR receiver module. While the pictures are going, I would like to use YouTube's hashtag #StayHome. Take care of each other and try to stop the novel coronavirus by staying home. Do some experiments, build some circuits, now is the time to come up with great electrical inventions and also keep our elders healthy by not spreading the virus. Thank you for watching, share this video on social media if you like it.